bus contracts, it says, are plagued by skyrocketing cost and suspected anti-competitive practices. Gina Mangieri has more on tonight's top story.
Joe, the DOE says many of the attempts to correct the system are already in place, though the audit points out a federal investigation. But the biggest challenge, a multi-million dollar budget gap, remains unresolved.
Nearly one quarter of Hawaii's public school students rely on the school bus to get to and from campus, with ridership strained by dozens of route cuts due to a massive budget cut after costs shot up. It's a system the state auditor says is out of control. According to an audit released Friday, there have been no competitive bids in years. Bids unjustifiably rose by as much as 259%. There's no systematic approach to monitoring performance, and the DOE compensated contractors for their general excise taxes, which the DOE itself acknowledges is unusual for state contracts.
I looked at that as well and said, well, this is silly. So in our quest to bring transportation in the 21st century, that's also something that has to be addressed.
The DOE has a new person in charge of the bus contracts and has engaged a mainland consultant for just over $100,000 to reform a system it's spending tens of millions on each year.
Because you've got the audit, you got a new guy, you got a mandated, you know, almost half budget slash, and you've got momentum to change this.
The audit questions how costs almost tripled since 2006, while only one out of nearly 50 route bids reviewed were competitively bid. The audit says the DOE has cooperated with a federal investigation into possible antitrust violations by school bus contractors, but said that does not absolve it from its responsibility to report suspected anti-competitive practices. State Representative Marilyn Lee said the DOE and BOE must improve their procurement, delivery, and oversight of student transportation services immediately.
There might be some statutes that need to be changed with regards to how we procure those contracts so that we do keep it in a competitive pricing environment.
The Bus Vendors Association did not yet respond to requests for comment. Gina Mangieri, KHON2 News, Hawaii's news leader.